So good morning all. So we'll start up the class with this particular question, which is asked in JEE Mains 2003. In the last class, also we discussed the same model. So in which a car is moving with speed. See, whenever we you're doing problem, first read for that is a car moving with speed 50 kilometers per hour. Then wait there. Okay. So and frame some image about that one. So now let me start like this. If I take a car, so till here itself I going with this one in the problem, a car. Now let me take a car. There's nothing but a car, right? So this is the car moving with, okay? It is moving with a speed U1. U is equals to 50 kilometers per hour. 50 kilometers per hour, right? Kilometers per hour. So now can be stopped after at least 6 meters, okay? After 6 meters. So here, it is a 2003 problem, okay? Now after 50, after can be stopped by brakes after at least 6 meters. Now that means it traveled a distance of, let me take it as 6 meters. It traveled a distance of 6 meters, V is equal to zero. The final velocity is becoming zero. Okay, fine. Now, if the same car is moving with a speed of 100 kilometers, that means same car I'll be taking. Now, same car is moving with 100 kilometers per hour. That means this is nothing but U equal to 100 kilometers per hour, right? Kilometer per hour. When it reaches, that means how much distance? So this distance we have to calculate before coming to rest. So here a uniform retardation, okay, retardation is constant. So we can apply, as we discussed, S proportional to U square. So if I apply S proportional to U square, any doubts? Anybody? Because this already, how we are getting S proportional to U square, we discussed in the last classes. Hope you remember this one. Yes or no? Yes? S? No. So S proportional to U square. If I use S proportional to U square, is there any problem for you? Anybody? Yes? No. Can I use S proportional to? Okay, fine. So S proportional to U square. Now S1 by S2 equal to U1 square by U2 square. U1 square divided by U2 square. Now let me take this is U1. This is nothing but U2. Here S1 is equals to 6 and S2 is equal to how much? S2 equal to how much? Simply substituting from here onwards mathematical parts. So S1 is given 6 divided by S2. S2 equal to, right? U1 by U2, U1 square by U2 square. U1 is how much? 50. 50 divided by 100. So I'll write 50 divided by 100 whole square. Completely it is whole square. So when it is whole square, this is nothing but 1s, this is nothing but 2s. So finally, I'll be getting 6 by S2 equal to 1 by 4 I'm getting. So what I got the equation, let me write here. So as 6 by S2 equal to, fine, 1 by 4 I got. So which is nothing but just a cross multiplication. S2 equal to, I can write 6 into 4, which is nothing but 24 meters. So most of them, most of the student posted correct answer. Congratulations, right? This is the correct answer. Okay, one should go with this one. So option is C. Good, all of you. Is it clear? Yes? Anybody? Any doubts? We are going with the JEE Mains 2004 question, which is given in offline. Okay. So a ball is released from the top of a tower of height H. So what I told, when you're reading the problem, just make a picture of that problem. Just I'm drawing now. So let me take, there is a tower. This is the tower of height. It's nothing but height. So height H. Let me take height H, right? So height h I'm taking, this is nothing but height h. Then I take a height h, that's all. A ball is released from the top of a tower of height h meters. So till here it completed. It takes t seconds to reach the ground, okay? It takes a t second. That means I'm dropping a ball from here, okay? So if it takes this ball, if I'm taking this ball, okay? So it is reaching the ground. Which is reaching the ground. When it is reaches the ground, what is the time taken? He is saying it as to reach the ground, T is equals to capital T. So that is given to us. So we'll stop here. So what is the position of the ball after T by 3 seconds? t by 3 seconds from the point of projection, that is when he dropped, right? Here, what is the initial velocity? Can anybody tell? When it is dropped, what is the initial velocity? What is u value? Yes, zero. So at initial velocity at this point is zero. Now he is asking us to calculate after a time. See, after a time of t by 3 seconds, after a time t by 3 seconds, when it reaches from the point t by 3 seconds, so what is the height of the what is the position of the ball after t by 3 seconds? Okay, that is from the ground, is saying. That means he is asking in the option, it is saying from the ground. So what is the height from the ground? Hope it is clear till this point. From the ground, what is the height? He is asking from the ground, what is the height? Right, how to calculate this one? Fine. Now what I'll do, I'll take first let me take two situations here. First thing is ball is freely falling. Let me take ball is freely falling. I'm dividing this into two parts. So when the ball is freely falling, u is equal to zero. Fine. Okay, most of them posted the correct answer. Okay, so let me see, two students till now posted correct answer for this this question. Okay, let me see. U is equal to zero. The time taken t is equals to capital T. Now, can you tell me what is acceleration here? What is acceleration? Plus g or minus g? Anybody? Minus g. So this is nothing but minus g. Now v is equals to, here what I'll calculate is what is the height. What is the height of that means height in terms of t. Height in terms of t first I'll do. So s is equal to ut plus half a t square. Ut plus half a t square. Okay. Ut plus half a t square. U is nothing but zero. So what is the distance here? Yes, S is nothing but what should I write? S is equal to plus h or minus h. Can anybody? Plus h or minus h. What should I write? S is equal to plus h or minus h. Very good. Most of them posted minus h. Very nice. So minus h equal to, this nothing but a zero plus, that is nothing but minus a half g into capital T square. So minus minus gone. So h is equals to, if I take h is equal to first half g t square. You keep it like this. So for time being, you keep it like this, right? So h is equals to, right? H is equals to half a gt square. Now, next, at a time t is equals to t by 3. So what is the height from the, what is this height traveled? I want this height traveled. So let me take in the second case, this is nothing but complete distance. So that is, or a displacement or a height of a tower, this is nothing but minus h. First case is completed. Let me take this nothing but case 1 I am taking. Now case 2, what I'll take? Case 2. I'll go with the case 2. What is a case 2? Now case 2 can be written as, so initially it is falling u is equal to 0 and t by 3 seconds. So u is equal to 0, t by 3 seconds. What is the distance? Now I can write directly h is equals to 1 by 2 into g into t square. T square means t square by 9. So t square divided by 9. Right? Let me take, this is nothing but h1. This is h1. Now h1 is equals to half gt square divided by 9. Hope it is clear. Half gt square divided by 9. Now what I can do, what I'll do here, let me see. So h1 is equal to half gt square by 9. Here I'm getting h totally is nothing but half a gt square. So we'll find it out, a relation between h and this one. So now I would like to do here problem. See, now h1 can be written as h by 9. Am I right? H by 9. Yes, no. Boliye. H1 is how much? H by 9. Because h1 can be written as, if you have any doubt here, okay. H I'll write now 1 by 9, you take it as common, into 1 by 2 into half g t square. Half g t square. Is it clear this one? Half g t square. So half g t square is nothing but h. It is nothing but h. Now h is equals to, what should I write? 1 by 2 into 1 by 9. 1 by 9 into h. So there is nothing but h by 9, which is h1 is equals to. So what is final conclusion here would like to draw? Fine. So if I take this part, so from the point of projection, h1, right? No need of taking 9.8. Simply you can keep it as 9. It's g itself. There is no problem. So h1 is equals to h by 9. From where it is h by 9, can you tell me? From where? From the top of a tower. Right? V is asking you to calculate from the bottom. Can you tell me from the bottom what is the remaining distance? Anybody? From the bottom, what is the remaining distance? You understood till this point? Case 2. See, case 2, if I take, right? I'll go with the case 2 here. See, case 2, what I'm doing is, let me clear this one. Somebody posted to explain case 2. See, case 2, 8h by 9. This will be 8h by 9. Remaining distance will become 8h divided by 9. See, till case 1 understood, no, all of you? Yes, no, boliye? Yes? Okay. Now case 2, if I go, okay, case 1 understood, no? Okay, case 1 understood. Case 1, what I am trying to do, I am dropping a ball from certain height and taking time t seconds. So just I am writing s is equal to ut plus half a t square, right? S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Fine. Then s is equal to minus h minus 0 minus half a gt square. Fine. So let me explain the case 2 now, right? Now see, case 2, what I am supposed to do here, I want to calculate only from, you see carefully, from where to where u is equal to 0 to t by 3 seconds. How much distance it is traveling in a t by 3 seconds. So now what I'll do, same thing, s is equal to, let me take, this is nothing but h1 I'll be taking. So what is h1? H1 is nothing but h1, this is nothing but a h2. H can be written as, now h is equal to h1 plus h2. Total distance is h1 plus h2. How I am dividing? First, h1 is nothing but time taken to reach in t by 3 seconds. Remaining distance will be 8h by 9. That's all. So case 2, the same thing. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. I am using ut plus half a t square. Okay. Now, can you tell me here S? What is S? Anybody? What is S? S is minus h1, right? So S is nothing but minus h1 is equals to ut 0 plus half into minus g into t square. T is how much? T by 3 whole square. Okay, t by 3 whole square. That's nothing but a t by 3 whole square. So that's nothing but a h1 is equals to, I'm getting a 1 by 9. If I take it as outside, then I can write a 1 by 2 into gt square. Yes, sir, no, all of you. Now let me, is it clear this one? Fine. Now 1 by 2, that is h1 equals to h by 9. So this is nothing but h1. So h1 is how much? h by 9. Is it clear this one? Yes, h by 9 is a downward, that is, he is asking the question here. Okay. We want to calculate, according to the problem, we want to calculate from the ground. From the top of the tower, it is h by 9. From the bottom, it is 8h by 9, right? So most of them will get confused and they will write h by 9. Okay? Is it clear? So, Srija, hope it is clear. Fine? Yes or no? Srija, why we are subtracting? Because we want height from bottom or top. Bottom or top, can you tell me? Srija, from the bottom. From the bottom means I got from the top. I got from the top. H1 is equal to h by 9. Hope it is clear now. Fine. Is it fine? From the top. Okay. So from the top it is h by 9. From the bottom it is 8h by 9. So from the ground is asking in our question. According to the question, we have to calculate, because there is no option with respect to top of the tower. If it is with respect to top of the tower, then it is the correct answer for us. It is the top of a tower, your answer is correct, h by 9. From the bottom of the tower, it is 8h by 9. Hope it is clear to everybody. If you have any doubt in this one, let me know. Anybody, any doubts? Yes, boliye. Anybody? Anybody? Just a moment, I'm trying to fix this one. Right. No doubts. Test syllabus. Govardhan test syllabus is? Test syllabus, right? Test syllabus is distance displacement. Yesterday also announced. डिस्टेंस डिस्प्लेसमेंट, ओके, वेलोसिटी एवरेज, वेलोसिटी एवरेज स्पीड, एक्सेलरेशन, इन दैट एक्सेलरेशन काइनेमैटिक इक्वेशंस, व्हाट एवर वी आर डूइंग काइनेमैटिक इक्वेशन, राइट, सो प्रॉब्लम्स दैट विल बी देयर, राइट, नथिंग टू वरी. द फर्स्ट एग्जामिनेशन ट्राई योर लेवल बेस्ट, बिकॉज टू अकस्टम यूर सेल्फ टू द टेस्ट विल बी गेट अ प्रीवियस व्हाट. मानसी कुछ बोल रहे क्या? Can you post what is Mansi? Mansi, what are you saying, Mansi? Mansi saying that sir, derivations, no, it is nothing but multiple choice. Sir, test will get previous GE questions. So previous GE questions, maybe you get previous GE questions. Okay, so I don't give the paper, so paper will be from somebody will be giving the paper, fine. So it will be common to all the branches. It will be common to all the branches, okay? Is it clear? How many marks and all those things? They'll be saying 10 questions means each question will be 4 marks will be there. Negative marking will be there if you make any mistakes, right? Is it clear? How many marks? That's what. Each question will be 4 marks. It is 10 questions. Normal pattern, they don't go mostly. We'll wait and see by the pattern. So don't worry about the pattern. Fine. So pattern, if one question carries 4 marks and if you do mistake, then you will be going a negative mark. So you should be very sure when you are attempting the examination or posting your answer. Fine. I think hope everything is cleared. Yes, no, boliye. Yes, shall we proceed? Yes, chalo. Now, just to take a screenshot here. Hope this is understood by all. Yes, yes, no, boliye. Yes, okay. So, hope it is, yes, okay, fine, good. Now, just to take a screenshot, right? Done. Okay, we proceed. Now next, moving to one more question here. We'll go to, so I'm going with one question, right? Let me start up a question here. So if I take in, let me consider a problem. See, problem is like a tap, okay? So let me take a tap. So a tap. a tap drops water, okay, is it clear? At one second intervals, right? Fine. Find the distance between. You may ask, find the distance between third and fifth drop. You may ask second and third drop like this. Third and fifth drop. When? Okay. Sixth drop, right, is just coming out from the tap. Is it clear, this one? From the tap. So let me show the scenario how it looks like here. So let me consider a tap here. See, there is a tap, right? There's a tap. So water drops are falling down. So if I take water drops, so first, sixth, first drop, second drop, right? Third drop and fourth drop, right? Fourth drop, fifth drop and sixth drop, right? Is it clear, this one? So here we are giving the name for this one is sixth drop. This is nothing but sixth. Here it is nothing but five. This is nothing but four. This is nothing but three. This is nothing but two. is nothing but 1. Like this, it will be there. So you may ask at any interval of time, right? So you may ask you to calculate the distance between a 6 and 5 or a 5 and 6 or 4 and 3 or a 6 and 2, anything, right? So I am taking that, what is the distance between third to fifth drop? So third to fifth drop, how much distance? Third to fifth drop we require, right? So third to fifth drop, how much distance? This distance I have to calculate, third to fifth distance, right? Now how to proceed with this problem? Okay, that's important. So if I want a distance from a third to fifth, what I can do, first thing, I'll calculate the distance from a 6 to 5. First I'll calculate from 6 to 5 distance. I'll calculate, let me take it as a h5, so that is a fifth drop will travels a distance h5. I'll be taking, now let me take, these are the intervals already given, intervals are given, so equal intervals, what is that, 1 second interval. Interval is 1 second each. So if I take 1 second each, okay, I'm taking 1 second each. So here I'll take, this is nothing but 1 second, 1 second, here also 1 second, here also 1 second. Only we require till this point. You may ask even till down also, there is nothing to worry about it. See, H5, if I calculate, then if I calculate H from here, that means first let me calculate H5. Then what, how we can proceed, let us see. Fine. So here U is equal to fifth drop, and it is coming, it is like a freely falling. So let me take a drop is falling downwards, it is falling downwards. Initial velocity is equal to 0. Now can anybody tell what is A is equals to? Okay. So what is U is equals to? A is equal to, anybody? What is A is equal to? Can you bol sakte kya? What is A is equal to? Minus g, let me take it as 10, so that we'll be getting so 10 meter per second square. If he says that acceleration due to gravity, then I can take minus 10. Okay, minus 10. So minus 10 meter per second square. Okay, acceleration I got. Now what I required to calculate here, s is equal to ut plus half at square for fifth drop. If I want for fifth drop, so what is the distance? S is equals to ut plus half at square. Now carefully see, fifth drop is moving, okay, from here, see, from this point to here, it is fifth drop is moving, that means fifth drop is moving in downward direction. So S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is equal to ut plus half at square. S can be written as now minus h5, am I right? Minus h5, because it is coming in downward direction. U is nothing but 0 minus half gt square, which is nothing but 10 into how much time to travel distance from 6 to 5? 1 second is given. So it's nothing but 1 square is 1. So this is 1's how much? It is 5. So your negative negative sign get cancelled. H5 is equals to 5 meters. Hope it is clear right now. Fine. H5 is equals to 5 meters. That means fifth drop travel a distance of 5 meters. Fifth drop is traveling how much distance? 5 meters. So here it is nothing but 5 meters. Fifth drop is traveling 5 meters distance. Or if I want to show here, this is nothing but 5 meters. Hope it is clear. Right? 5 meters. Okay. Now what we have to calculate? We want a distance from 5 to 3, right? That is, according to the question, we have to calculate 5 to 3. Now, let me start for third drop. See, third drop, so it traveled from fifth to till this point. Let me take it as H3. This is nothing but H3. Let me calculate H3 here, right? I calculate H3. That means starting onwards, I'll calculate. See, for third drop, what I'll do, I'll calculate third drop. Third drop anyhow is to release from the top, right? So I'll calculate now, this is nothing but H3. This is H3. Once if I calculate from 6 to 3, the third drop will comes from 6 to 3, H3 distance, right? So if I want 5 to 3, what should I do? What should I do? Can anybody tell? See, 6 to 5 is 5 meters. I'm going to calculate 6 to 3. If I want 5 to 3, what should I do? Very good. So H3 minus H5. This distance will becomes now. So H3 minus H5. So if once if I calculate H3, then if I subtract, I'll be getting the answer for that one. Now let me take first case is over for fifth drop. So fifth drop ka over. Fifth drop is completed. Fifth drop. Now we'll go with the third drop. Third drop. Third drop has to travel from where to where? 6 to 3 it has to travel. 6 to 3. That means it is like a freely falling only. U is equals to 0. U equal to 0. Then A is equals to minus G, which is nothing but a 10 meter per second square. Okay. Then what is the time taken? Can anybody expect what is the time taken by the third drop to reach from the tap till here? Anybody? 3 seconds. Very good. Most of them gave 3 seconds. See, third drop has to travel from 6 to 3 till this distance. That means 1 plus 1 plus 1 second plus 1 second plus 1 second. How much it is? 3 seconds. So this will become almost 3 seconds. Hope it is clear. This is nothing but 3 seconds. 3 seconds. Now you can substitute what is the distance traveled. S is equal to H3 I am taking. Now S is equal to UT plus half AT square. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. S is equals to UT plus half AT square. Right? S is equal to UT plus half AT. So most of them posted the answer also for this question. Okay. So S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So S is nothing but I should take plus or minus. Can anybody tell? Plus or minus H3? Plus or minus H3? Minus H3. So minus H3 is equals to U. U is nothing but a 0 minus half. This is nothing but into 10. Into 10 T square. T square is nothing but 9. 1's a 5's a, right? So minus minus will get cancelled. H3 is equals to 45 meters. Hope it is clear. 45 meters. Yes. Yes. No. Boliye? Yes. Okay. Let me. Fine. So I can take now. This is nothing but final expression. H is equals to 45 meters. H5 is equal to 5 meters. Now I want H3 minus H5. That is a distance between third and fifth drop. So if I want a distance H3 minus H5, if I write H3 minus H5. So H3 minus H5 means H3 is 45. Yeah, very good. 45 minus 5, which is nothing but we are getting 40 meters. This is almost 40 meters. 40 meters. Is it clear, this one? All of you? So this is the distance between fifth and third drop. Hope it is clear to all of you. H3 parts. Fine. H3. The distance is traveling. That is H3 is nothing but we are starting from 6 to 3. That means third drop has to travel from the tap starting point till here. So 6 to 3. Okay. 6 to 3. U is equal to 0. A is equal to minus 10 meter per second. T is equal to 3 seconds. S is equal to H3. Simply you will be substituting there to get H3 is equal to 45 meters. I think H3 minus H5 is nothing but 40 meters is the answer. Okay. So most of them got the answer. Congratulations for them. Okay. So first a particle is moving east with velocity 5 meter per second. So this is the first question I gave to you all as a homework yesterday, right? So let us discuss here. Let me draw north, south, east and west. First, north, south, east and west. North, south, east and west, like this. North, south, east and west. Okay. So a particle is moving towards east. See, whenever you are doing problem, try to represent in a pictorial form. That will help you to solve easily the problem. Right. First, I'll take a person. A particle is moving towards east. Let me take a particle is moving towards east. So it is moving towards east. Carefully give the answers to my questions, right? With 5 meter per second. So 5 meter per second. Shall I take 5 I cap or 5? Simply 5 meters. Or you can also take 5 I cap. Nothing to worry. Now, in 10 seconds, the change in velocity changes to 5 meter per second. 5 meter to 5 meter per second, right? So it changes, if I take like this, is changing its velocity towards north. Which is nothing but a 5 meters. 5 meters towards what? North. Towards north. Can you tell me? Can I use parallelogram law of vector addition? Because I want acceleration. I want acceleration. How to calculate acceleration here? What is the formula for acceleration? Can anybody tell how to define acceleration? Anybody? Yes. No. What is the definition of acceleration? You both sakte kya? So delta V by delta T, Jimmy. Okay, delta V divided by delta T. Delta V divided by delta T. That means change in the velocity, magnitude if I take, change in velocity by change in time, right? Fine. So I want to, first I should calculate change in velocity and its magnitudes, right? Change in velocity, if I want to calculate change in velocity, what is change in velocity? Final velocity minus initial velocity. Final velocity minus initial velocity. Delta V is V2 minus V1. So if I take here, what is V1 now? Here it is nothing but V1. Initial velocity is V1. And final velocity is nothing but V2. Am I right? V1 and V2. V2 minus V1 I have to do. Fine. But to do minus of V1, I require a negative vector. Right? First I want to add these two vectors. Let me add two vectors. So if I want to add V1 and V2, so can I add by this process? That means here one head is there. Here it is, tail is there. Head plus tail is there, right? Head plus tail, can we do? Can we add this one? No. So what we have to do? Can anybody? So those who attended, yeah, bridge course, we discussed about parallel shift, tail and tail. Now what I'll do, I'll shift this one. I'll shift as a parallel shift, okay? I'll be using the concept of what parallel shift. Concept of parallel shift I am using. When I use the concept of parallel shift, just I can draw one line here. If I draw one line, that is, it is shifted here. Now this will be shifted vector, right? This is 5 meters now. Okay. Now I have two vectors. This is nothing but final velocity. V2 is equal to 5 meters. V1 is equal to 5 meters. This is towards north, right? Now I can erase this one as I did parallel shift. Now I'll erase this one, right? So if I erase this one over, right? Yes or no? Right. So this is nothing but parallel vector, right? Now I have this one, right? Parallelly shifted V1 and V2. Now I want V2 minus V1. So what is the meaning of V2 minus V1? Can you tell me? V2 of plus minus of V1, right? Minus of V1. That means I want a V2 vector and a negative of the other vector. So we already introduced the concept of negative vector, right? Can anybody ask what is the negative vector? Anybody say what is the negative vector? Koi bol sakte kya? What is the negative vector? Negative vector, koi bol sakte? Negative vector. What is the meaning of negative vector? Negative vector. Okay. So it should have same magnitude but opposite in direction. So what I'll do, I'll create a vector which is in the opposite direction to this one. That is nothing but. I'll take one vector which is in the opposite direction to this one. Now, this is nothing but a negative vector of V1. Now, I can write this is the negative vector V1. The forward direction, this is V1. This is nothing but V2. Both should have same magnitude but opposite in direction. So, it is indicating towards what? West. It is towards west. Right? So, now I can write vector subtraction. If I want a magnitude delta V for a subtraction, that is V2 minus, that is plus of what? Minus V1. Or simply V2 minus V1. Simply V2 minus V1. Vector difference. What I want is vector difference. V2 minus V1. Vector difference I want. Yes. Vector difference. Is it clear? So how to calculate the magnitude of vector difference? Anybody? How to calculate the magnitude of vector difference? Koi hai? Bolne wala? Magnitude of vector difference. Kaise calculate karte? Anybody? Parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay. Parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay, chalo. Okay, now we'll continue from here. So now I have V2 and V1, which is nothing but the magnitude. Now how to calculate magnitudes? Now I can calculate magnitude delta V is equals to under root of V1 square plus V2 square plus, V1 square plus V2 square minus 2 V1 V2 cos theta. V1 V2 cos theta. This is nothing but magnitude of difference of vectors. Now can anybody tell what is the angle? What is the angle that we are getting? Anybody? What is the angle? Right? Anybody tell what is the angle? Angle koi bol sakte kya? Theta is equal to how much? Theta kya hai? Theta is equals to 90 degrees, right? Theta is equal to 90 degrees. Because this is angle is how much? 90 degrees given. Now simply substitute. Now magnitude will be getting delta V is equals to substitute karo under root of V1 square plus V2 square. Okay. V1 square plus V2 square, that is 5 square plus 5 square, which is nothing but 5 square is 25 plus 25. 25 plus 25. We can write here delta V is equal to 5 root 2 meters per second. 5 root 2 meters per second. This is here V1 meter per second. Here also meter per second. Okay. meter per second. Is it clear? This was phi root 2 meter per second delta V we got. Now, how to calculate acceleration? I got acceleration is phi root 2 divided by delta t means 10 seconds. So this is 1 2 za. So I can write now 1 by 2. 1 by 2 means 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2. That is the acceleration. So if I want to write the resultant for this one, how to write the resultant here? Okay, resultant can be drawn like this. This will be the resultant, right? So resultant will be this is the direction of resultant. So this is the direction of resultant. So resultant is projecting in which direction? Can you see here? Resultant is north of west. So this is nothing but resultant. North of west. We are deciding north of west V2 to V1. So north of west, how much angle it is? 45 degrees also we can say. Because V1 and V2, if I take V1 and V2, if they are equal magnitudes, always the resultant will bisect from the center. 45 degrees, 1 by root 2, 45 degrees, north of west, option is A. Hopefully most of them got this answer. Congratulations. Just try to take a screenshot here. Here, see, acceleration direction is along the direction of change in velocity. So change in velocity, we are calculating V2 minus V1. So V2 minus V1, if I take V2 is towards north direction, towards west. That means V2 minus V1. With respect to V2 and V1, we are giving the direction for it. Otherwise, we can write a simple manner. Delta V can be written as now. Delta V is equals to, in IJK vector, if you are thorough with IJK vectors, delta V is equals to, this is a north direction 5J. And west direction minus 5 I cap. So if I take 5 common here, J cap minus I cap. Now you can give the conclusion here. J is towards north and minus I is towards west. So that north of west also, we can say this is one of the method that we can. Okay, now this is given in a JE Mains 2012 offline question, which is based on average speed. Hope you can see this is an average speed problem. So in the previous classes, we discussed how to calculate average speed. Here, let me draw the diagram. See, saying that according to the problem, a car covers the half of the car covers first half of the distance between two plates. That means let me take this is the complete distance A and B. The half of the distance, exactly half of the distance. Let me take this is half of the distance. D and remaining half of the distance is D. So what should I take at that point? Total distance should be taken as a 2D. I'll take. If I take total distance is 2D, half of the distance is D, remaining half of the distance is D. Right? Half of the distance is D and remaining half of the distance is D. Now he's saying that it is moving with a speed of, first one is with the speed. So first half of the distance, let me take C is the center. First half of the distance between two places, 40 kilometers, other half. So V1 speed is 40 kilometers per hour. And V2 is nothing but here. V2 is 60 kilometers per hour. Kilometer per hour. Okay, kilometer per hour. Here also kilometer per hour. Right. It is kilometer. So V1, V2 is there. What is the average speed? See, already in the previous classes, we discussed average speed auto calculate 2 V1 V2 divided by V1 plus V2, right? So if how we are getting this average speed, you can check it out in the last classes, right? How we calculated this 2 V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. Directly I am taking the formula for it. Okay, now if I substitute this values in the equation, then average value will get 2 into V1. V1 is 40 into 60 divided by 2 V1 plus V2. That is nothing but 60 plus 100. So 0 0 0 0 gaya. So 2 4 2 into 4, which is nothing but 8 8 6, how much? 48 kilometers per hour. Hope this is very clear to all of you. This is the average speed. So average speed equals to, final answer is 48 kilometers per hour per hour, right? So this is nothing but 48 kilometers per hour. Hope it is clear to all of you. Fine. Right. Good. So ball is released from the top of a tower. See, whenever we are doing any problem, what you do is like, first read the problem. for certain extent and try to make a pictorial form. That means you have to draw the diagram for it with respect to your imaginations. Then we have to proceed. So in that way, in that process, what happens? It will be more comfortable for you to solve any sort of problems. So let me take first a ball. A ball is released. Sorry, just a moment. So ball is released from a top of a tower. Now let me take there is a top of a tower. This is a top of a tower. It's nothing but a tower. Tower of height h. Let me take there is a height of h. So total height for the tower, I'll be taking h. This is capital H. The total height of h. Now small h he has given. Let me take it as small h. It's nothing but small h. So ball is released from the top of a height h meter. It takes a t seconds to reach the ground. That means a stone is dropped from a top of a tower. Let me take a stone is dropped from here. So this is the stone dropped from the top of a tower. It is dropped from top of a tower. It takes a time t is equals to capital T seconds, right? So let me take this is the case one. Here initial velocity. What happens to initial velocity, right? Can you tell me what happens to initial velocity? U is equal to zero. Am I right? Initial velocity. So I have initial velocity, time, and h. So is there any relation between these three things? If I take acceleration, what is acceleration when it is coming downwards? Anybody? What is the acceleration? It's coming downward direction.
Minus
negative.
Negative.
Minus 10.
Yeah, it's very good. It's nothing but negative. A is equal to minus c. See u, a, t, and h. See combination of this one. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. I can use. So now what I'll do? Case one. I'll take it as case one. In case one, what is the information that I have? Let me write s is equal to ut plus half a t square. Ut plus half a t square. Ut plus half a t square. S, if I take, S is nothing but coming downward direction. So S I should take. In this case, S is equal to, when it is coming downwards, what should I take? Positive or negative? Negative. So minus h. So I'll be taking now minus h. U is nothing but a zero plus a half. Half into, again, A is nothing but a minus g into t square. Into t square. So negative, negative will get cancelled. So h is equals to gt square divided by 2. So t is already given capital T. So what I'll do now, 1 by 2 into g into capital T whole square. So let me take this completes. What is the time taken to reach? So let me take, this is nothing but h1, right? Half a gt square. See what I did now? A ball is released from the top of a tower of height. It takes t seconds to reach the ground. What is the position of the ball after t by 3 seconds? That means let me take it is h1. Now distance traveled is h1, which is nothing but h1 is nothing but h. Right, h1 is nothing but h. Let me take it as h. Right, next case 2. Going with case 2, carefully see case 2. In case 2, what I can, how I can proceed? Let me see. In case 2, see, let me take till this point, it is reached. So from u2 till this point, the time t is equal to t by 3 seconds. T by 3 seconds. If I take t by 3 seconds, how to calculate? Now u is equal to 0, t by 3 seconds. I don't know the distance. Let me take this distance or displacement is h1. Now I'd like to calculate h1 by the same process. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. So now S is equal to ut plus half a t. So that is nothing but case 2. S is nothing but coming downwards minus h1. U is again a 0 plus a half, which is nothing but minus g into t square. T square means t square divided by 9. Now I can get now h1 is equals to minus minus will get cancelled. So 1 by 9, if I take it as common, I can write a half a g into t square. Half a g into t square. So h1 is equal to 1 by 9 into half a g t square. So if I want to write in terms of h, then I can write h1 is equals to, here I'll write h1 equal to, or I can write h1 equal to h by 9, right? This can be written as h by 9. So here if I write h by 9, so what is this meaning of h by 9? H by 9 to travel t by 3. That means if we ask, according to the problem, what is the distance traveled in a time interval of, that is from point of projection after t by 3 seconds is h by 9. And from the bottom, if you measure, see from the top to t by 3 is h by 9. Remaining distance will become h minus h by 9. Am I right? H minus h by 9 is nothing but 8 h by 9. Right? 8 h by 9. See, here two answers is a possibility is there from the top of a tower. It is h by 9 from the top of a tower. From the bottom, it is h by 9 from the ground. That means C will be the option here. Hope it is very clear to you. Fine. Is it clear? H by 9. 8 h by 9 f- from the bottom, and from the top it is h by 9, but h by 9 from the top it is not given. Fine, just take a screenshot here, and just a moment.